Hey guys, so today in the garden, I've got a lot of lettuce coming up. Let me show you. So these two beds, so I believe there's a third bed right there. So one, two, three. And they're lined for the walkways with some of this, which is just chips made from branches of the trees around here, as well as some of this, which is just a bag of leftover stuff that we use in our composting toilet. And in here, let's see if I can find you some lettuces sprouting. Let's see, right down there, right there, and not so much in this one, however, and it could just be I'm not looking close enough, right there. They're hard to see when they first come up. This is about a week ago I planted these. I didn't take notes, unfortunately. Right there, right there. All over this bed. Right there, right there, right there. There, and there, and there, all over this bed. There, there's also some weeds, and I definitely need to go through here and weed all this. I don't know if I already pointed this out, but there's some lettuces you can see sprouting up this bed as well. This is all red and purple and sort of a multicolored medley of lettuces. I tried to pick ones that'd be frost hardy. We're still getting down slightly below freezing, down to 28 degrees, 29 degrees. But these do seem to be coming up and making it. So they are pretty tender and tiny, but they are making it, which is exciting. I didn't even put black plastic down or anything here. I don't have hoop houses made. I wanted to use that approach, but there's just not any budget for anything right now. We really have nothing. It looks like I may have finally gotten some work. Really crummy work, but at least it's work from home. Hopefully that works out and I can finally start bringing in some money so I can actually make progress on some things. Lately, all my effort has been focused on this vehicle, the Toyota. I redid the rear seals, inner axle seals, and brakes, and they seem to be holding. There's a busted stud in there that I need to replace, but everything seems to be holding together, nothing leaking so far. I'm going to tear into the brakes today and double check if they're leaking. Also, I'm trying to fix my tailgate. The latch is broken on it. But yeah, this has all been redone. It's still got a really nasty misfire, so, and I've narrowed it down to almost guaranteed fuel injectors at this point. I can't, based on all the testing I've done, I can't even fathom anything else it could be. So found a place locally that'll rebuild the injectors or clean them, deal with them basically for $25 a piece. So I'm going to take them down there and hopefully get this truck back on the road. It still needs some other stuff like a mirror and a passenger seatbelt buckle and some other stuff like that. But it's steadily getting better and better. And I think pretty soon it'll be comfortably drivable. The other big thing I had to do yesterday was... I don't actually recall. Oh yeah. So I had this truck worked on by a shop, a local shop, and I think they actually did a decent enough job, but I don't know if it was them or the previous shop that forgot to tighten that. You see, I threw a random cotter pin in there, but that was super loose and jiggling and the truck was wandering all over the road. So I tightened that up and now the truck doesn't wander all over the road. I may also try to adjust the power steering gearbox to get myself even tighter steering, although it's pretty good now, but there's still just a tiny bit of play in it. At this point, the entire front end has been replaced. Every front end component that moves or deals with motion or cushions motion or anything has been replaced, so it should be good, and it's been aligned. The brakes have been completely redone on front and back, so it should be all good now. And it's just a matter of adjusting the rear brakes, and hopefully that'll make the truck drivable, and then doing the fuel injectors to get rid of that misfire. And then I'm pretty much done. It still needs some other little things. Like I said, this is another little thing it needs. It needs a latch for this, and the latches are not expensive. I just haven't had any money for a long time, and I've just been focusing on kind of bare mechanical needs. I don't drive a whole lot. This is mostly so Caitlin can get to work, and so that we do have a way to get in and out, at least, for supplies and building materials and things of that nature. I'm also working on this building over here. I'm at least wanting to get started on it, even if I don't ever finish it. I don't know. I just want to try and build us a bathhouse so we have a shower and a toilet that isn't a composting toilet. And it's going to have some, you know, a septic and things of that nature so that it actually functions as a bathroom. This section will be probably 10 by 12 for our bathroom utility room thing. And it'll either contain IBC totes, or we'll get the well fixed on the other side of the road and then run a water line across the road for this side. Because my family does have a well over there, but it doesn't work. It only puts out about maybe 40 gallons a day or every couple days. So they're going to try to get it serviced and see if they can bring that back up to, you know, a couple gallons a minute. So that we can all have water again. And we'll probably still have a water tank over here because there probably won't be enough pressure to run multiple households. I don't know. We'll see what happens after they try to service it. There's some other work. We got to pull the pump out and stuff over there. But yeah, today I'm going to run over with the tractor and grab the jack and jack stands and some plywood and jack the truck up and see if I can adjust the brakes. So that's my big project today, and I have a few others. Going to try to make some pine tar to treat the wood for that. If I do that project, whenever I do that project, I'll film it, show how I did it. I might just buy pine tar at this point if I have money for it. But, I mean, we're surrounded by pine and we have plenty of metal buckets and pans and things and jars, so could also just make it. Anyway, that's kind of what's been happening around here. Nice and peaceful. We're finally not dealing with so much logging noise for a few minutes at least. They started really early this morning, about 5 in the morning. And now it's quiet and peaceful. Anyway, thanks for watching, y'all. Have a good one.